मॉर्निंग इज सतोगुण, दिस इज ब्रह्म मुहूर्त टाइम, वेरी पायस टाइम टू थिंक अबाउट, दिस इज द टाइम टू थिंक अबाउट स्पिरिचुअल लाइफ, इंट्रोस्पेक्ट, यू नो एवरी डे. नाउ व्हाट यू स्टार्टेड एज अ हैबिट, लेट इट बी अ कंटिन्यूस हैबिट, पार्ट ऑफ योर लाइफ नाउ. That was a time, I remember my Nana, Nani, Dada, Dadi, all of you know that. Morning time, they will read Shastra. The time to think about life, what am I doing in life, why am I doing, who am I, what Bible is God. And then Shastra is so beautiful. You read that, once you get little faith in that, you got an idea. But it has to be reinforced, no? When you read different pastimes of the Lord, you read so much discussion, so many tikas, bhashyas of the acharyas, and morning is the time. Now suppose you want to read Bhagavad Gita after this course. I invest 1 hour a day and read the whole chapters and read the way I showed you I read. Every word you should mark and try to understand. And how nice it is then. Okay. And the basic level faith will come because you're all wonderful devotees. But then it has to go deeper and so many details more. Faith gets reconfirmed. See, what's the difference between us and our hero Hanuman? What is the difference? Only faith. He's also a devotee, we are also a devotee, but what is our level of faith?
Focus, not every day.
So his faith is so strong. His faith is so strong that Lord Rama gets shaken up when he meets him. And he, you know. So can you see this? Like this you should read. Every word you should read. So you have the books with you, hard copy or soft copy. Just sit down and every day read word by word. Understand every word. Nothing should be, and I'm with you. I'm doing the same reading. Suppose you don't, so I don't understand that purport, that shloka, that word. I'm with you. Always. Okay? So please feel free. Okay. So we are now in the Bhagavad Gita and we are in the 7th chapter today. So congratulations everybody for finishing 1/3 of Bhagavad Gita. But I tell you one thing. If you want to understand Gita, you should do this course 4 times. You will know what is where. Oh, that chapter, that is there. This chapter, this is there. Okay. And still, if you can read the actual contents of Bhagavad Gita word by word, your understanding will be very mature. Okay, now we have to locate day 7.
Sir,
rewind
on my phone.
Okay, he's just starting.
Hare Krishna, welcome. In the previous chapter, we discussed Ashtanga Yoga and stages of Ashtanga Yoga practice, Rahasi Sitaha, and very important point I revealed to people, Rahasi, he has to stay in a very isolated place to practice Ashtanga Yoga. And why control the mind? Abhyaseyena tu Kaunteya. Krishna says by regular practice, the mind can be controlled. And destination of unsuccessful yogi, Shuchi Naam Srimatam Gehe. He is, you know, born in a family of pious people or in an opulent family. And Bhakti Yoga, the topmost yoga, was the last shloka of the last chapter. Yogi Naam Abhi Sarvesham Madgata Antaratmana Shraddhavan Bhajate Umam Samyeku Tamomataha. And now we start on our whole section of 6 chapters on bhakti. After concluding that bhakti yoga is the topmost yoga, as I showed to you, yoga means bhakti yoga only. But when there is attachment to the fruits, that become polluted, it becomes karma yoga. When there is attachment to my own imagination and speculation, it becomes polluted and it becomes Jnana Yoga. But actually yoga means only Bhakti Yoga. Yoga means connection to the Lord, how it can be anything else. So now let us take up Jnana Vijnana Yoga, knowledge of the Absolute. Different ways we can name every chapter, but I like this name, Jnana Vijnana. Okay, we'll see why. Maya Sakta Mana Partha Yogam Yunjam Madashayaha Asamshayam Samagrama Yathagya Sasitashano. This is a favorite shloka of Srila Prabhupada. It says, how by practicing yoga in full conscious me, Maya Asakta, Arjuna, become attached to me, Mana Partha, this shloka is just immediately following Krishna's declaration in the previous chapter, my devotee is the greatest yogi. So it's going in the same breath. Maya sakta manapartha Arjuna become attached to me. Yogam janjamat ashaya. Take total shelter of me. This kind of yoga you follow. Asamshaya. If you do that, what is going to be the result of that? Asamshayam. Without any doubt. Samagram. Completely. Yathyagya sasitashano. Therefore, hear me. Now, at this point, I have something really interesting to you, that in other religion, both the speakers said, there is so much more for me to tell you, but you are not ready now. There is the exact statements which are there like that. I want to tell you so many things, but you're not aware. Because the situation is different. Here is Arjuna, look at it, so pious. Before the war, he says, Arjuna, Krishna, can you forgive them? Let us go away. I don't want this kingdom. Let them enjoy. Such a saintly person. From childhood, Bhima was given poison. If somebody gives poison to you, he deserves death penalty. Their house was burned. He deserves again death penalty. So much things, sins were done to them. But he's ready to forgive everything. So Krishna, let them enjoy their kingdom. I don't want this war. Even if they kill me, I want to attack me. Apratikaram, ashastram, I am not armed. I will not protest. They can kill me also. I don't want this war. Very saintly person. And definitely, therefore, he deserves to be told the whole truth. Krishna says, asamshayam, without any doubt, samagram. See, desha kala patra is the situation for teaching. Desha means the place, kala means the time, and the capacity of the recipient. Based on that, you teach. But Krishna is choosing to tell Arjuna, I'm going to tell you everything. You know, when Srila Prabhupada was asked, because he was widely spreading Krishna consciousness movement all around the world. So some people came to Srila Prabhupada and said that, we also have a religion here. Prabhupada said, yes, but father knows always more than the son. that was one argument. Because always the reference to father in heaven. Prabhupada said, yes, Krishna is their father. And father always knows more than the son. And second time, Prabhupada used to say that this is the most effective process. The teachings of Bhagavad Gita is the most effective process to become God conscious. So asamshayam, hey, Krishna is saying, without any doubt and completely you will understand me, Arjuna, if you follow this process. Maya sakta manapartha yogam yunja madashaya. That's very beautiful. And shunu, you know, at the end of the day, hearing Krishna, nothing greater than that. The Lord is speaking. So Krishna is saying, just hear. It is said the spiritual life is, the foundation of spiritual life is Shravanam. In the Navaveda Bhakti, the most powerful medium is Shravanam. Even in your studies, see, the materials are lying all around. There is iron somewhere, there is stone somewhere, there is cement somewhere. But when you hear to the teachers in the college 4 years, you get enough knowledge to construct a skyscraper. So by hearing only, everything happens. You go to college mainly for hearing. So spiritual life also, everything happens by hearing. But we don't have the patience. Take care. Patiently, if you just hear what Krishna is trying to say in Bhagavad Gita, life will be different. I shall not declare unto you this knowledge, both phenomenal and nominal, by knowing which there shall remain nothing further to be known. But something what we can see in this world is material, and nominal means the spiritual. Whatever is there, Arjuna, I'm going to teach you everything. So he is encouraging Arjuna. Oh, this is a jewel of a shloka. Manushyanam sahasheshu kashyati yatati siddhaye yatatam api siddhanam kashyamam veti tatvataha. This is, you know, nowadays popular. These things are only popular in the world today. They will not gather for any spiritual activity. People are so much today bodily conscious. I feel so unfortunate. Early morning time, the time is reserved, should be strictly reserved for spiritual life. People are running on the roads, trying to improve their body. You will leave their body, health or no health. You should be very conscious of this foolishness. Health or no health, you cannot stay in the body one more second than you are destined to. This health will not save you. True, it's not that we don't take care of the body, but this overcare of the body, the madness of the Western civilization. Early morning running on the roads, early morning doing exercises, very unfortunate. This is the time meant for spiritual life. At least first spend time for spiritual life. Just like people are so conscious of physical muscles, what about mental muscles? What about spiritual muscles? The predominantly this time is meant protected, should be kept aside and protected for spiritual life. But today people have become just animals. So much body, with the fit body also people died. Just check with the doctor, sudden heart attack, gone. The body will not save you, and the Lord will save you. You know, they think, ye dhana yauvana putra parijana ite ke ache parati tere. Ye dhana, your money will not protect you when death comes. Yauvana, your youth will not protect you. Parijana, neither your relatives can protect you. Krishna will protect you. But read about him. This is not the time for all these things. So, manushyanam sahasreshu, among thousands of men who are so foolish, kashya yatitse, there is one man who is more intelligent. No, let me spend the morning time understanding God. That morning time is always free. But another thing is that night we should not delay too much. It's good to sleep by 10 maximum. That's best. Then automatically, how much you'll sleep? 4, 5, you'll get up. Then you have the, at least you get some time. And how beautiful is the atmosphere in the morning time. Because all crazy people are sleeping. And you know, atmosphere is so sattvic. At that time, if you sit down to chant, read, it'll be so nice. Yatatam apsukashit, somebody achieved perfection in a spiritual life among thousands. Yatatam apisiddhanam, those who achieve perfection, hardly one comes to know me in truth. So it's very rare to know Krishna. It's not easy, one in a million. So you're all one in a million. Because you decide, see, ad was open, small ad, I didn't spend any money, just put in Facebook. But you people all saw it. Huh? Whether millions of people saw it, but you chose to take advantage of it. So you are already one among many. I am not encouraging, Krishna is encouraging. Bhumiyapu anulovayu kammano buddhi evacha ahankara itiyamve bhina prakriti asada. Now Krishna is saying the eight energies of mind, the material world is constituted of eight energies. What are the eight energies? Bhumi apo anulovayu. Bhumi means earth. How do you define earth? Bhagavatam explains, earth is defined as something which is perceived by all the five senses. You can see it by the eyes, you can hear through it by the ears, you can smell it by the nose, you can taste it by the tongue and touch. So any object you can do that, that is earth. Particularly the predominant quality of earth is smell. And then earth, water, the smell goes away now. Special quality of earth goes away. You can't smell pure water. But you can see it, you can taste it, you can touch it, and even inside water you can hear, or water can give sound to you to hear, either way. Then go fire. Now fire, you cannot taste fire. So you cannot taste, you cannot smell, but you can hear, you can touch, God forbid. And then hear, touch, with more sense, and you can see. Earth, water, fire, air. Air, you lost the sight also. You can't see. But you can feel the presence of the air by moving your hand. And you can hear through it. Then ether. Ether, you cannot feel. But you can hear through it. It can carry the signals. Now, what is ether? Honestly, truthfully telling, I do not know. But there is an element. I only read by little study of quantum mechanics when I was trying to reconcile science and spirituality. I was shocked to say quantum mechanics declares there is no vacuum in this universe. What classical physics previously talked about, there is vacuum, there is no vacuum. It declares there is no vacuum, there is something. Similarly, science is also speculating on something called dark matter, dark energy. They say we do not know 95% of matter what it is. Perhaps my guess is that might be ether. Because Krishna, the science says what we see, there is something which you don't see when matter is there. It's not electrons and protons as we know, but there is something. That's what they are talking. They have speculated that by seeing their mass of the universe. And what they see doesn't add up. So there is something which is invisible and having mass. Whichever way you take it, there is something called ether. This is the so we know only out of the eight, modern science knows only first four, but they all exist. The creator is speaking, I designed, Baba, it's there. So earth, water, fire, air, we know. Ether, we do not know, but it exists. That the sky, there is some matter there. It's not empty. And then after that is mana. Science does not know that. Definitely it does not know, but we feel the mana. We are the mind. We have mind. All of us are disturbed by that. And generally we say mind, but it can be divided into three parts, the subtle body, mind, intelligence, and false ego. Intelligence is, my mind is sankalpa vikalpa, I like it, I dislike it. And intelligence is determination. Just like you're fasting, it's a determination. You are having diabetes, you see sweets, I want to eat. Mind senses smell it. And the mind says, I want to eat. And what the intelligence says? No, this life, forget it now. So that is intelligence. We do not know many people, we have intelligence. That is another truth. And then we never exercise our determination. We do have. Our intelligence can become very sharp and strong in good company and association. Just like when you read Bhagavad Gita, not only it purifies the mind, it sharpens your intelligence. So the moment some sinful activity is proposed to you, just cut it off. You just cut it off because intelligence becomes sharp. So earth, water, fire, the mind, and then ahankara. I am the enjoyer. I am independent of God. I am like that, controller. I am creator. What all these big scientists are infected with. Big ahankara. You are nothing, sir. You are like an insect. One little poo, you'll be blown away. Like in Japan, I was watching those days, I saw the tsunami. And I was just seeing how small we are. Little nature fury, when America, when the tornado come, whole country is under panic button, only people are running here, there. You're powerful, no? I heard you're very powerful, super powerful. Stop that hurricane, no? They can't do anything. They just run away. So that is their power. So earth, water, fire, either mind, intelligence, false ego. The false ego means it's wrong, ego. I am a servant of Krishna, real ego. Some people say you have to remove ego. No, don't remove ego. Remove false ego. Like Hanuman, who are you? I am a servant of Lord Rama. He has great pleasure in saying that. Yes, he's so proud of a great master. Great. That's not wrong. Real. But don't have false ego. I am God. Don't speak that nonsense. You're not God. God is always God. Dog is always dog. God does not become dog, and dog cannot become God. And don't take out that imagination, hallucination, foolishness from the mind. You'll ever become God. That post is already occupied. Eternally occupied. He is naturally the master. We are naturally his servants. And that is perfectness. So Krishna is saying, these are all my energies. Earth, water, fire, ether, mind, intellect, false ego, bhinna, prakriti, ashtada. They are my eight material energies. Bhinna. Bhinna means separated. Separate the self, just like this class, you can record and you can hear. I don't come to know, even if you hear that. But it's my energy because I'm making the sound. The same way, these are all Krishna's energy, but bhinna, not directly connected, bhinna, separated energy of the Lord. And then Krishna says, beside aparetustu anyam prakriti viddi me param jiva bhuta mahabhavo yedad dharitam jagat. Krishna says, beyond this inferior energy, there is a superior energy of mind. Jiva Bhuta Mahabaho. Arjuna, beyond the inferior energy, the superior energy. Jiva Bhuta, that is the living entity. Okay? This is, you can see, the living entity. Kayedam Dharate Jagat. Everywhere these living entities are there. And they're sustaining this universe. So there are eight energies, and very important to note on, Krishna has declared us also as an energy. Energy is always controlled by energetic. So voluntarily we should come under the control of the Lord. That's our position. Natural Krishna saying, you are my energy. You are not enjoyer. You are enjoyed. You are not controller. You are controlled. You are not creator. You are created. We all belong to the Lord. Just like a hand belongs to the body. The hand should serve the interest of the body. If suppose your finger is not working. You go to the doctor. Doctor, doctor, this finger is not working. Move! You look at your finger and say, move, because you can order. Therefore, Krishna at the end says, Arjuna, saradharman parityaja mam ekam sharanabhaja. Take my shelter, Arjuna. Give up all these foolish ideas you are having. Take my shelter. So Prabhupada says, Krishna can demand it actually. Not only Krishna requests us, not only request, he can order also. We are his servants. We are his dasas. Always the master has a right to the dasa. Hey, bring a glass of water. He has a right. So Krishna requests us, because we are in part and parcel, to engage in his service for our good. Not that he's short of servant. Lakshmi sahasra shatasam ravyaseve manam. Millions of Lakshmis are waiting to serve the Lord with great respect. Don't think it's shortage of servant. Just like company, they're shortage of employee, they come for employment. So Krishna has come to this metal world searching for some more employees. No. Don't think like that. There is no shortage. But he's coming for our good. We will become happy when we engage in his service. So we are his energies. There is a superior energy mind, which are the living entities. And because of that, things are going on in the metal world. Everything is going on, running around. They are the one running around and, you know, shaping this world. Then Krishna says, "Oh, conqueror of the world, there is no true superior. Nothing is superior to me, Arjuna. Everything rests upon me as pearls are strength on a thread. There is nothing superior to me." So we should forget that idea there is something higher than Krishna hiding behind Krishna. Many people have this idea that behind Krishna is God which does not have form. Krishna is saying here, nothing is superior to me. Hare Krishna. Oh. Hare Krishna, Premi Kishori Mataji. Yes, what is the shloka? There is nothing superior to me. Matta paratara nanya
kanchitasti dhananjaya.
Yes.
Ti matva bhajante mam buddha bhava samanvita.
No, that is another shloka.
Sai Prabhu.
Okay. Matta paratara nanyat. There is nothing, no true superior to me. Just as pearls are strung on a thread. Of all that is material, all that is spiritual in this world, know for certain that I am both the origin and dissolution. Okay. Now Krishna starts explaining how he is present in the matter. Why this is important? Because if you want to see Krishna in the spiritual world, you should also understand first, matter is visible to you, no? Spirit is not visible to you. So through matter, Krishna is explaining. Just like you want to meet the Prime Minister, you have to go him his way. So therefore, Krishna is giving a way by which we can gradually develop love and respect for him. He says, rasoham apsukanti. And now, is there something, somebody who doesn't drink water? Yeah, everybody drinks water. So yes, Krishna says, I am that water. So how can somebody say, I cannot remember God? You are drinking water, no? Yes, I do. Krishna is saying, I am that water. Rather, saying, I am the water, Krishna says, I am the taste of that water. And you drink water. Rasoham apsukanti. Prabhasi shashi shurya. The light of the sun and the moon. You can look out of the windows. In India now, sun is rising. Okay? So, I am the light of the sun and the moon. Yes. Is there somebody who can avoid that? No. So, you can always. So where is the difficulty in remembering Krishna? Pranava sarva vedeshu. Through all the Vedas, I am the word Omkara. I mean, all the Vedic mantras begin with Om. Some people say, in Vedas, there is no talk about God. Sir, don't enter this fool's paradise. There is a lot of discussion about Krishna in all the Vedas. Because Krishna also said in Bhagavad Gita, Vedesh sarve aham eva vedya. Through all the Vedas, I have to be known. It will come in the 15th verse. But even if you have not read those verses glorifying Krishna, in every portion of the Vedas, it is being Krishna has been glorified. Because Krishna himself said in Bhagavad Gita, Vedesh sarve aham eva vedya. Any Vedic verse begins with the word Om. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. Om, everywhere there. Om Tad Vishnu Paramam Padam Sada Pashyanti Surayaha. Anybody knows any more verse with Om beginning?
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Yes. Om
Namo
Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Tene Brahma Hidya. No, that is one verse. Okay, no. Any other? Yes, here is Shri Vaishnava come. Om Narayana Nama.
Om Vishnu Mangalam Guru Garbhaja.
Yes. So we can see Om is very everywhere. You all agree or not? Every verse begins with Om. Krishna says, I am that one. Krishna said, I am that Om. So how can you say there is no Krishna in Vedas? You know?
Krishna, Om, Krishna, Om, Krishna.
Yes. So everywhere Krishna is there. They say there is no Krishna in Vedas. What is this you are talking? You have not read the Vedas, for if you speak that nonsense. Even if not read, at least from outside, you know, every verse because it's Om and Krishna says, I am that Om. Pranava Sarivai, I am that Om. So that Om is referring to Krishna. The personality of Krishna, that is what we refer to. Shabda ke paurusham nishu. And I am the sound and ether and ability in man. So this is the list actually. Taste in water, light in the moon and sun, Om in the Vedic mantras, sound in ether, ability in man, fragrance of the earth, heat in the fire, life of all that lives, pinnace of the ascetics, original seed of all existence, intelligence of the intelligent, prowess of the powerful man, strength of the strong.
Small doubt, Prabhuji.
Sex life
not has been said by Lord Kartikeya. Na?
What is that?
Om has been said by Lord Kartikeya. In the books.
What is it? Kartik, why are you bringing Murugan and Kartikeya here? He's just a devata. Devata means they're administrators in this world. They're not God.
Okay.
He's an administrator and we have to give him respect for that. He's the commander of the Devata's army, correct? Skanda. Anna?
Okay.
But he's not God. He's just like Indra, we don't say Indra is God. Now it will come, Krishna will talk about all this.
Okay.
But we have all respects for him, no problem. See, we respect all the Devatas. And they got appointment letter from the Lord in that connection. Now Krishna will talk about this, okay? So please just stay for some time. All states of being, be their goodness, passion, ignorance, are manifested by energy. And I am in one sense everything, but I am independent. I am not under the modes of material nature. Look how beautiful this painting is. So Krishna is saying, I am not in the modes. He is beyond the modes. What happens when a king visits a jail sometime? It is out of kindness for the prisoners. At that time, he is not under the control of the superintendent of the jail. King is not under, he is free. So we saw that if Krishna came to this world, he was any power, like lifted a mountain itself effortlessly with a small finger, or any rules of this world. Krishna is not bound by anything. He's the Supreme Lord. Deluded by the three modes of goodness, passion, ignorance, the whole world does not know me, who above the modes and inexhaustible. So Krishna says, I am not in the modes. Just like a king coming to the jail. He's not bound by any rules of the jail. He can go anywhere he wants in the jail. He can do whatever he wants in the jail. There is no rule for him. He comes to this world actually to meet his devotees. Krishna doesn't come for anything else. And just see, as a well-wisher, to see how everybody is doing here. Okay, so because we are covered by Maya, goodness, passion, ignorance is a sweet way of telling Maya. The mode of goodness, nothing. Maya only, little less Maya. And passion, more Maya, and tamoguna, total Maya. So we are all covered in Maya, but Krishna is beyond Maya. Maya cannot touch him. And we, because we are in Maya, we cannot see Krishna. It's like, very nice example is given, just like cloud. Cloud is formed by the energy of the sun, and cloud can cover us, but not the sun. Okay? By the energy of the sun only cloud is created, but cloud covers us. We can't see the sun after that. Similarly, by energy of the sun, God, Maya is there. And those who have foolish desires, they are put into Maya to satisfy those foolishness. Because in reality, our illegal desires or illogical desires cannot be fulfilled. I am the controller. This desire, I am the enjoyer. It cannot be fulfilled in reality. You are not. You are none of the two. You are controlled and enjoyed. But you want to be controlled and enjoyed, that is fulfilled in Maya. Namam Krishna Moda Prapantyante Narada Maha Maya Prakashana Asuram Bhava Mashitaha. Namam Krishna now says, four kind of people cannot understand me. Namam Dushkrita no Muda. Muda means a donkey. He has no time. Many times we say people, this is Dushkitana means he is very notorious, we say, miscreants. He has intelligence but misuses intelligence. You know, Kriti. Kriti is their activities. Dushkriti. Just like Duryodhana. The Dushkriti makes him, you know, a little disturbing element. So four kind of impious people, miscreants, are not able to understand me. Number one is Muda. Now people don't appreciate or understand that's bad. But out of the four, I tell you, you will only understand one of them. But we have these four elements within us. Therefore, we are not able to situate it in the Krishna's glories. So we should hear that, not that somebody else it is talked. Even we have this element to some degree. Muda means doesn't have time. Did you chant your rounds? No, I didn't get time yesterday. Yeah, Muda. Muda means it doesn't have time for spiritual life. Prabhadyante Naradama. Naradama means sinful person, lowest among mankind. That's Prabhupada even gives in the purport stricter definition. Somebody who doesn't take advantage of human form and keeps engaging in material activities puts as Naradama. And attached to the body and think in illusion attached to the bodily relations. But we will take a more simpler definition. Naradama means lowest among mankind. The simple Sanskrit definition. Maya Aprahita Jnana. Maya Aprahita Jnana means knowledge is stolen by illusion. Aprahita means stolen. Maya. Maya stolen intelligence. He become too proud of himself. Just like the scientist. They have typical Maya Aprahita Jnana. Little few gadgets they made, some mobile TV and the jumping. Maya is stolen there and they are very proud. In science, there is no place for God. Yes, sir, in your science, your silly science, it is not there. Asuram bhav mashitaha. Very, very envious and jealous of the God's existence. Like all the rakshasas, we call asuras. You know, we say no, so many banasura, agasura, asura. They're all list of asura. Asura means they hate the presence of God. They see God, they attack him. So these are the four kind of people Krishna says they cannot understand him. Nama Muda, Naradama, Maya Pratakyana, Asura Bhava. You can see now. Now who is what? Any guess?
First is Muda.
Donkey is representing the Muda. All day the donkey is busy serving the master. End of the day, that master, look at how much he has loaded him. At the end of the day, he will give him a little grass to eat. Because he's donkey, he doesn't understand. Grass is everywhere. I don't have to really work for this idiot. But he's a donkey, he doesn't understand. Therefore, he's donkey. Donkey means foolish. You know, it's a typical name for a foolish donkey. And look at him, what he's doing. And he's walking naked. Huh? He doesn't have one piece of cloth on himself. All day work for the master. And he has no time for spiritual life. Typically, he's symbolizing a man who has no time for spiritual life. All day working for so-called master. And what they give him, chafala sukha lava lagere, some foolish happening. And the right side, you see extreme right, that is jagai madai. This is a beautiful pastime of Lord Chaitanya. In which jagai madai were two very, very sinful people. They represent Naradama. And in the center is some asura, probably Ravana, doing some tapasya. To get some power to... See, nothing wrong to do tapasya, but why you want to get power to harass other people? That's Ravana. These are all demons. They hate the existence of God. Then Krishna says, on the positive light, the four kind of people never surrender. Now it's four kind of people who surrender, and they are Sukriti. Chaturveda bhajante vam jana sukrituna arjuna. The four kind of people, not the four kind of people, Krishna says, surrender to me. Chaturvida, what are they? Sukritini Arjuna, what are they? Artho. Artho means little difficulty. And that is also the reason today. A lot of people are taking interest in Bhagavad Gita because they are very pious at heart. Any person who is impious, when there is difficulty, they don't go to God, they curse God. I am such a nice man, you did this to me. And that is demon. But a pious man, my Lord, please give me shelter. It's very difficult nowadays. No business, no money, no so many people have lost jobs. And you cannot even look for a job now. Because companies are finding difficult to even retain the employees. And you know, they employees have worked with them for 10 to 20 years, therefore they are keeping. But I meet the manager, say, what do we do? There is no business. Artho, and the disease is only increasing in India at least. It's not peaking at all. Artho. A difficulty. Some pain is there, physical. Artha, arthi. So artho means some pain. just like the man you can see with, you know, who's injured, is praying. Artho, Artharthi, the man with two small kids, I have to maintain a family, my Lord. What am I supposed to do? Artharthi, please help me. Jnani, the man in knowledge holding the book. And the Jigyasu, with the hand finger like this, who is inquiring. These four kind of people, if they are pious, they come to God. So when they come, they are definitely neophytes. They're not that they're very advanced devotees at that moment. But no, because they come to God, gradually they will. Very Krishna says they are so nice. Just like son comes to meet the father. Father is very happy. Doesn't matter for what reason they came. He's happy they come. But these four, you see other four idiots. What I said, Duskritano Muda, Prapadyante Naradama. Naradama, you can see that man holding the hand above. All four kind of people are there. Duskritano Muda. Muda is that idiot carrying a load on his shoulders. Let us identify. No, Duskritano Muda. Prapadyante Naradama. You hear this fellow. Maya Aparita Jnana, this fellow. Even reading Shastra, so many people read Bhagavad Gita, they say there is no Krishna. Bhagavad Gita minus Krishna, very good. And then Asura, very envious of the existence of God. He thinks he is the greatest man on earth. These four are impious, those four are pious. Now there is an exercise. You look in the next one. Next one, you see, there is, I'm going to show you something. Look at who is what. These are different, look at, so many pictures are there now. Yes, start the exercise. Who is Artharthi? Who is Jnani? Who is Artho? Four kind of people surrender to God. One is Artho in pain. One is Artharthi in looking for some wealth. Jnani looking for knowledge. A Jigyasu is inquisitive. Anybody start?
First is Draupadi is Artho.
Artho, great.
The elephant is Artho.
Rajendra is also Artho. Yes.
Draupadi is Artho.
Okay, these two understood. Everybody identified Draupadi. This is Artho.
Fourth is Jignasu.
Fourth is Jignasu.
No, what is this? Who is this person? Dhruva. This is Artharthi. He went to the Lord, give me a kingdom bigger than my great-grandfather Brahma. This is Dhruva. He went for some assets, some land, sthana. Then who is this personality? Meeting Lord Rama, making a sandhi for something.
Vibhishana.
Sugriva.
Bali.
Yeah, Sugriva. He wants a kingdom which Bali has snatched away. So Lord Rama says, okay. You help me, I help you, right? And he kills Bali and enthroughs him. So he wanted from the Lord what? Some wealth. Artharthi. Okay, this much is over. Now, inquisitive. Jigyasu. Parikshit Maharaj. Very inquisitive. What is my duty? My death has come, my Lord. Shukadev Goswami, my death has come. Please guide me. So Jigyasu. This is the sages of Naimisharanya, Nimshar. They are asking Suta Goswami. Please, we want to know Jigyasu. Yes. And this is Jnani. This is, who is this person? Anybody knows? He became very big in the womb. I have been talking about him. 14 years he was there in the womb of his mother. It is Vedavyasa in great difficulty. Yes. Shukamani. And Krishna comes and gives him a promise. Don't worry, my child. Maya will not touch you. Please come out. He was telling, the world is full of Maya, I don't want to be born in this world. And he was growing and growing inside the womb. Very extraordinary situation. So Krishna came and he instructed Shukamani, why you are giving so much pain to your mother? No, I don't want to come out, Krishna, this world is full of Maya. So Krishna says, I give you Ashirvada, Maya will never touch you. So he's a Jnani, very knowledgeable person. So okay, I identified like that, we can do so many more instances on Shastras we can put like this. Interesting.
Prabhuji,
Guruji, just for clarification, Guruji. You said distress is Artho.
Artho.
Artho. And desire of wealth is Dhruva.
Huh?
Desire of wealth.
No, Dhruva went for wealth, no.
No, desire. Dhruva means wealth, right?
Dhruva, no, no, Dhruva, Dhruva Maharaj. Here is Dhruva Maharaj.
No, no, desire of wealth, what do you call in Sanskrit?
Artha, paisa, paisa, artha, arthaarthi.
Artha, what is Dhruva?
Dhruva Maharaj, arthaarthi. He wants some wealth. He wanted a big kingdom. Jigyasu is inquiring from Shukamuni. He is the grandson of Arjuna. He is inquiring from Shukamuni. Please tell me what is my duty. My death has come.
Okay.
He got close to die within 7 days. So he asked from Shukamuni, please guide me. What is my duty?
Inquisitive is the same as the knowledge of the absolute.
Huh?
Inquisitive, is it the same as the knowledge of the absolute?
No, that is different. Knowledge is here.
What do you call it in Sanskrit?
Jnani.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Jigyasu is here. Jigyasu and Jnani. True, I appreciate your point. Who is Jigyasu will definitely become Jnani tomorrow. That I understand and appreciate that point. But at this stage, we have to little differentiate between them because here is inquisitive, here is the knowledge. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so the Prabhuji,
can you repeat which type of people who surrender are there in the pictures?
No, but you know the four kind first. Let me
yes,
see the Artho in pain. Here I showed you this person in pain. You see his body is pain. My Lord, please help me, my Lord. So he's nothing wrong. He's going to the God. But I tell you one thing, great devotee never ask anything. Pandava never asked the Lord. We have so much pain. What Krishna now? Vanvas? What is this? Nothing. Artharthi. He wants some wealth. My Lord, I have to maintain my family. What do I do? You know, we had a very unique instance. You'll not be able to believe. Somebody contacted us. And here is a Rohan. He contacted him. He said, I was about to commit suicide with my whole family. Because of this pandemic, I lost job. There was no money at home. But after hearing Gita, I didn't do that. So, artharthi. Sometimes people are pious, they pray to the Lord. Give me some direction, some hope, my Lord. When this pandemic will end, there is no money at all. So many people are just receiving half salaries now. And so, artho, artharthi. And then, jnani. There's a person, jnani. He knows the Shastra, understood the Shastra, and said, yes. He approaches the Lord. And here is jigyasu, inquisitive. So, these four people approach the Lord. They are pious, Sukritana. Sukritana means they are pious. Therefore, in this situation, they go to him. These are, you can see, crazy bump. So, you identified now? So, Artho is pain. Gajendra was in great pain. He remembered the Lord. Draupadi also in great pain. She remembered the Lord. And here is Dhruva. And he wanted some place. Here is Sugriva. He also wanted something. Kingdom back. That brother had taken away his wife and kingdom. And then here is Jigyasu. There is Parikshit Maharaj Jigyasu and also the Sage Nameshwarana Jigyasu. And then this is Jnani, the very special person, Shukamani, the speaker of Bhagavatam. Now, of those in knowledge of pure devotion is the best. Why Krishna's those in knowledge among the four is best? Because knowledge person will stay with him. But those people who come out of pain, they run away when the pain is over. Say when the money, I've gone to colleges just before the day of exam. You have seen what the crowd in the temples. They're all little ringing there. Kuch padha nahi hai, Bhagwan bacha do aaj. They'll all go. But the day the exam is over, you cannot see them. You know, before the day of the college, some college you have gone, the temple is there. They all are ringing the bells like anything that day. All the temples will be ringing bells. Loud bells you can hear. The day after college, now they are free. They can come to temple. No, they will not come. They will go to Goa, Manipal. Yeah. They want to enjoy in our life. So they are, among them, therefore, Jnani is best because he will stay with the Lord. He understood what it is. Other people, they come with some problem and moment problem in the world, they run away. Bahunam janamanamante. Krishna says, after many, many births, you can know me. Bahunam. After many births, you can know me. It's not easy to know Krishna. Gyanavan ma prapadyate. He said, after many births, you can come to my shelter, Krishna is saying. Vasudeva sarvamiti. Bahunam janvanamante gyanavan ma prapadyate. After many births, you come and take shelter of me. Vasudeva Krishna is everything. Samahatma sudullabha. Such a great soul is so over here. So, if you are going to surrender to Krishna after many births, why don't surrender now? Bahunam janvanamante gyanavan ma prapadyate. People in knowledge, So any field of knowledge you're studying physics, you're studying chemistry, mathematics, you have to come to conclusion. At the end, there is only Krishna. There is nothing else is there. That's what Krishna is saying. After many births, you will understand. Those who minded destroyed a metal disaster and demigods and followed the particular rules and regulation of worship according to their own natures. This is a very, very strong statement by Krishna. He said, only when your mind is affected by metal disaster, you ignore to come to my shelter. You run away to some Devi Devatas. How can Krishna make such a strong statement? That if it is not his worship, that worship is stolen by metal desires. Why has it gone away? Because try to understand this point, very important point. Devi Devatas can only fulfill your metal desires. Just somebody is talking about Kartikeya, very popular in Tamil Nadu, the worship, Murugan, Kartikeya. That is for material desires. But Hanuman can serve Lord Rama without any material desire. He is not desiring anything. Why can't you serve Devata like that? You cannot do, because that is not their domain at all. To give spiritual happiness is the domain of the Supreme Lord. For serving the Supreme Lord, not only become spiritually blessed, you go back to his kingdom and serve him eternally. For serving Devi Devata, you get some material facility and you will go to their place, which is temporary. You know, the Devi Devatas is a post. The post is temporary. You are temporary. The benediction given by them is temporary. But why somebody get attracted to Devi Devata Puja? Because they are going to get some temporary material benefit. Just like in a jail. The people in the jail, administrators in the jail, can only give you an extra chapati. That's it. They cannot release you from the jail. So that much freedom Devi Devatas have to bless you with material facilities. But mostly people are only interested in that. Therefore, Krishna is saying, Kames taste hita jnana yajante anya devataha tam tam veti kaunteya sadat bhavitaha. So this way it is there. Krishna says, actually, when they are so much having the strong material desire and they approach some devata, I only make this desire strong in that point. Okay, you worship the devata, you get your facility. And all such faith, they seek favors from a particular demigod and obtain desire. But he does not know actually what? Maye vihetam hi etan. That all these benefits are given by me alone. He doesn't know. He doesn't know. Look at it. All Devi Devatas are regularly going and praying to the Lord. Whenever there is a problem which they cannot solve, just like Kamsakya condition, it happened in Krishna book, previously Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakashipu, they go and pray. They all go to Shira Ocean. All the Devatas pay obeisances to the Lord and they pray. Okay? But in actuality, these benefits are given by me alone. Maye vihetam itetan. I have to sign the file. They cannot give anything independent of me. So if everything is signed by him only, why don't directly go to him? Why you want to take a benefit from a Devi Devata? When you directly go to Krishna and ask, the problem is why they go to the Devi Devatas. Krishna, you don't have to ask. He's sitting in a heart. But he's not giving because Krishna knows it's not good. You have been very, very irresponsible. Say, somebody goes to the is praying always in his heart or is desiring. Krishna is in a heart as Paramatma, he knows everything. If you're desiring to have a beautiful car, now Krishna knows every time I gave car in so many births, last 100 births, every time he misused. And he uses for giving to parties with his friends and drinks and does all nonsense. So he's not giving you. You're not getting money to purchase the car. Therefore, they run to Devi Devata. And that's irritating for Krishna. Why, my dear child, come. Why you are avoiding me? Say, take an example. Your child has gone to America after 20 years, is coming back to your city. How you will feel when he avoids you? You feel so much pain and anguish. He's not coming to meet you. He even goes to your neighbor and asks something. Can you tell the father that I need his personal car for a few days because he has come down to India? I said, why don't you come, my dear child? I'll give you more. I'll buy a new car for you. You come, no. But he avoids. How much it pains. Therefore, Krishna is saying, but I give those benefits, but some of these people avoid me. Men of small intelligence, Krishna then speaks even more stronger. Alpa medasa means buddhi is very less. Worship the demigods. They avoid me. But what is the danger? When you take a thing from the devata, it comes without protection. You bug a neighbor. You tell father, no, I want a car. And then he comes, your son is eating my head. He wants a car. Okay, give him. Even though he knows it's not good. What to do is forcing like that. Okay, So they quickly get the material benefits from the Devi Devatas, but they do not know Krishna is the one sanctioning at the end. And they are, Krishna is saying these people are of very little intelligence, small intelligence, because benefits are temporary. Alpa, the fruits are limited and temporary. Those who worship the demigods go to my planets or the demigod, but my devotees ultimately reach my supreme planet. Rohan, what is the shloka? 723.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Give me 1 minute, sir. I'll tell you right away, sir.
Yes.
Prabhuji, it is antavattu falam tesham tad bhaktvatya lape medhasam devan devayajo yanti mad bhakta yanti mavabi.
Beautiful. You are having Gita with you when you are studying this? Very nice. Yes, or it's in your, or Kantastha.
No, Prabhuji, Gita is there.
What's your name?
Pritha.
Okay. How many I'm 13 rounds?
Years old.
How many rounds are you chanting?
4 rounds.
Very beautiful. Okay. Just give me a few more minutes, I finish this. Take care. Unintelligent men who know me not think that I assume this form and personality due to their small knowledge, they do not know my higher nature, which is changeless and supreme. So there is another comment now. Many people think God has no originally, this is a very, very, very strong statement. So Krishna did not very much appreciate the worship of the Devatas. We know that. He was not quite happy with it. He is not recommending. And now Krishna is saying, I don't like this impersonal worship also. There's another way to avoid me. Why do you do that? So Krishna is hungry for the love of his children. Hungry. Just like a father comes back home. Everything he owns in the house. But a small child comes and brings one toffee. Papa, it's for you. He feels so happy. The toffee is from his money only. But the love, he's hungry for the love of the child. So Krishna is also hungry for our love. In the sense, for our own good. And he also enjoys loving transaction with his devotees. So he wants. But they avoid, one is the one way people avoid Krishna is Devi Devata Puja. Other way is this foolishness. That God has no form and personality. Now he has assumed form and personality. This is so popular, this atheism. This is another way of atheism. So popular in society. How can it be so? Krishna was standing in front of Arjuna with form and personality. In house, a picture of ancestors is there in every house. You see a father picture, form and personality. Grandfather picture, form and personality. All your friends, form and personality. How can Supreme Father lack form and personality? From where this idea comes, I do not know. Krishna is saying, no. Abuddhayaha. Abuddhayaha. These people have no intelligence. Avyaktam vyaktimapanyam manyate mam abuddhaya. Avyakta. The God has no form. Now he has assumed form. Avyakta vyakti mapanna manate mava buddhaya param bhava majananto. They don't know my superior nature. But this is assumed. And this is a big illusion going in the society and spread by so many people. So totally wrong here. Krishna is disagreeing with this concept. How can this concept be accepted? God has assumed form and personality. No. God always has a beautiful form. Eternally, he has a beautiful form. When he comes to this world, he comes in his original internal form. But very popular running is that if form is there, then he gets limited to a place. No, no, sir. He doesn't have material form like you. He has a spiritual form. In that form is present in everybody's heart. He's present inside every atom also. So, avyaktam vyakti mapannam manate mam ubhadvayaha. Due to their small knowledge, they do not know my higher nature, which is changeless and supreme. I am never manifest to the foolish and intelligent. Naham prakash sarvasya yoga maya samavetaha modoyam navijanati. I am never manifest to the foolish and unintelligent. Krishna says, no, I don't talk to nonsense. So he hides. Krishna is hidden for the unintelligent people. Therefore, they are not able to understand. They go to Devi Devata worship or they go to impersonalism. So I am never manifest. Naam Prakash Sarvasya Yoga Maya. By his own potency, Krishna is hidden. Therefore, Krishna is present on this world. Not many people could recognize him also. And therefore, deluded by the material energy, know me not, whom unborn and infallible. Oh, Arjuna, the Supreme Personality, Godhead, I know everything that happened in the past, all that is happening in the present, all the things that are yet to come. I know all living entities, but no one knows. This is another jewel. Yes, let us give chance to. I'm speaking today, I'm not given chance. Hare Krishna, Prem Kishori Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yeah.
Yes, Prabhu. You wanted
See,
to
I explain? Left only one verse for you.
So, thank you, Prabhu. Yesham te antagatam papam jana naam punya karma naam te dandva moha nirmukta bhajante maam dridavrita. Persons who have acted piously in previous lives and in these lives, whose sinful actions are completely eradicated, and those who are freed, give me my yellow notebook, those who are freed from the duality of delusion, engage themselves in my service with determination. So this is a qualification or a qualifying criteria to become Krishna conscious. Who can become Krishna conscious? The person who has acted piously in previous lives and in these lives. So that's number one. And then number two criteria, whose sinful actions are completely eradicated. So what are the sinful actions? What are the sinful actions? We think that mostly the sinful actions are the one that we are suffering from now, right? This is what we think most commonly. Oh, I must have done some sinful activity, so I'm suffering for it now. But actually, in Nectar of Devotion, in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami describes that we have four types of sinful reactions. One is called Prarabdha. Prarabdha means the reactions which are already fructified and giving distress and pain, like for the reactions that we are suffering already right now. And Phalanmukha. Phalanmukha means just waiting to take effect, like after some years, I'm going to get the reaction. And the other one is called as the Kuta. Kuta means the sinful reactions which are still in the dormant stage. And bija means which are still in the seed-like stage. So Krishna consciousness can be only tasted truly by people whose all four kinds of sinful reactions have been completely eradicated, who are freed from the duality of delusion. Duality means I like something, I dislike something. Hankering, lamentation, or sankalpa, vikalpa, like Prabhu was saying. Engage themselves in my service with determination, ridha vrataha. Otherwise, the determination, if we see ourselves that my determination in Krishna consciousness is shaking, then we have to go back and troubleshoot these four things. Prabhupada was asked by one of his disciples that, Prabhupada, what did I do so right that you gave me service, you accepted me as a disciple? And the person was thinking that that Prabhupada was saying, oh, because you're so sincere, because you are so committed, because you are so devoted and surrendered unto me. He was thinking Prabhupada will say like something like that. But Prabhupada said, you have nothing. There was no other option. You have no qualification. I made the qualification. So a pure devotee, by his pure mercy, can actually eradicate this first criteria and the second criteria. But the third and fourth criteria is in our hand. Like, how much am I engaging in this service? And proportionally, I'm going to get free from the duality. Prabhu, if you want to add something.
No, nice. Very beautiful. See this, if we do not, one side we practice spiritual life, and other side, just like I chant Hare Krishna, at the same time, I do not take care of sinful activities, then my realizations will not come. Theory will remain. Many times it happens, so many years, we are not getting darshana, we are not getting concrete, crystallized realizations. It is because the antagatam papam is not happening. So the result will not come. Prabhupada says, all the doubts will remain if we do not throw away the sinful activities. Yesham tu antagatam papam. Unless we are pure, God is so pure, so pure. Unless we are pure, we cannot enter into His leelas. Jananam punya karmanam, doing only pious activities. And dvanda. Dvanda is very important in this world. The dvanda comes when you want to enjoy materially, then dvanda comes. Suppose I want to enjoy materially, then a girl is beautiful or ugly. If I'm not, then there is not an effect at all. You want to eat cigarette, then one cigarette is good, another one is bad. If you're not, have no desire to smoke cigarette, then nothing is good, nothing is bad. What do you have to do with cigarette? No, this looks very attractive. Hey, take it away. You suppose you have decided, I'll not drink liquor. Somebody says, how nice it looks. What we are talking? Throw it away. So you are able to be away from delusion, advanda, when you give up the plan of enjoyment. And the dvanda is there, that is a proof of your submitted plan. Now Maya will dance. Moment your desire starts, Maya will only catch a criminal. Maya doesn't catch a devotee. So if there is a, this dvanda has started in the mind, that means I have some material desire. And this dvanda, moha nirmukta, we have to become free from the duality. Just like you go to kitchen to cook for the Lord. There is dvanda, it's heat, it's cold. To the degree you are very keen in the service, to that degree you ignore that dvanda. But very, very keen, you not even know it was hot. It was hot, I didn't know. I was so absorbed. Just like say, people are so attracted to sports today. And what happens to them? They say after the match, I didn't know it was so much pain was there. Because so much absorbed in that, for hitting that silly ball into that silly goal. What example I'm taking. So much absorbed. They go away from the dvanda, the body was painful or not, because they are totally... Okay, we did this chapter, I think. Those who know me, the Supreme Lord, the governing principle, the material manifesto, know me as the one who underlying all the demigods, the one sustaining all sex, can with a steadfast mind understand me, and you know me even at the time of death. So, there are five parts of this chapter. How can this is seven be written here? Oh. Rohan, this has to be corrected, huh? This. Icha dvesha maya vihita amitam. So Krishna, knowledge of the glory is a knowledge about Krishna. Kashyamam veti tatvataha. This is 30th shloka. So here, this from the previous chapter, this thing has come. Seven. How many shlokas are there in this chapter? 30?
30.
Yeah, now it's correct. So some mistake. Because, you know, we template the same chapter after chapter. Kashim Vamedi Tatvataha. So this is glory is the knowledge about Krishna. Manushyanam Sahasreshu. The whatever shlokas are, you know, in the notes you see as there, those shlokas please you cram. Actually, many more I wanted to keep. I consciously avoid, because I don't want you to, it's not possible for you to remember all. But what I write, those you should please try to remember. It will also become your vocabulary. See, when you're talking to somebody and you quote a shloka, they will worship you like God. It looks so emphatic. You give pramana, no, evidence. Like a lawyer in a court, he is giving evidence from the constitution. So same way you should give evidence when you're talking. Prakriti Vidhi Me Param. The knowledge of Lord Krishna's energies. Okay? That is
I
about soul.
I feel this with Mataji.
Yes. Mama Eviya Prapatnate, surrendering unto Lord Krishna. Demigod worship impossible. Maya Vihitami Yetan. Krishna says, I only give those things that you go to Devata's form. And delusion and devotion, Icha Dveta. Samudhi. Icha means like, dislike, come out all this thing. Then only you can come to Krishna. Too much you're disturbed by dualities of the world, you cannot focus on service to Krishna. You are cooking in the kitchen and too much you're bugged, it's so hot. Then you're not able to think about the Lord. You should tolerate the difficulties of this world. Okay, it's very nice to be with you. Now, I have some video to show you on mind control today. Before that, I know you'll love that video. We can have some question answers for say 10 minutes.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes, Mataji. What's your name, Mataji?
I'm Anshu Gupta.
Yes.
My question is actually not related, too much related to the context, but I would like to ask one thing. Like a father is there in the family, he never asks children that you always praise me, you always show your love, your affection towards me. Then only I will do something for you. Then I will consider you. That you have surrendered to me. And here, Krishna is asking. I'm not saying, I also pray.
Feel free. Open your heart. Otherwise, yeah. What is... Yeah. Just like Arjuna opened his heart, it looks like that. This. What kind of God is this? And now my father itself, I don't have to say my mother, Mama, roti milega aaj kya? Mama, roti milega aaj kya? She gives without asking.
So my question is,
God so asked, why is he asking? Okay.
Why Krishna always says,
Variya,
rest of the gods, they are only gods.
I got your question.
And I am the supreme. And if you surrender me, if you pray me, if you always chant Hare Krishna, then only you will be able to succeed in your life. Then only you will be able to get moksha or whatever.
I got your question. Variya Meshate Prashna. Beautiful question. See, the point is this. Without your asking, he's maintaining you. That you don't question. All the animals also is maintaining. That kindness he has already. Not that he's not maintaining. So many elephants without, they're not going to temple. They're getting food. And they need ton of food every day. He's arranging that. Your government doesn't reach a forest. Krishna is there in the heart and is feeding that fellow. But this is for special relationship, Krishna is asking. Maintenance, he will maintain you even you rebel against him. And he's doing that. How many of us can say we are praying or devoted to God? None of us. We are having the sun, moon, light, electricity, water to drink. Everything is giving. But the special relationship is what he wants from you. He's a father. He has come, you have left him. And he still come behind you. My dear child, I don't want anything, my child. I want your love. That's it. And for that, he's begging you. And you are saying, why is he begging me? That is his love. He doesn't mind that. You have seen sometimes child is leaving home. Father falls at the feet of the child. My dear child, don't go. It's not that the father is now smaller than the child. No. Isn't it? But still out of affection. Out of all affection, he's saying, my dear child, please hear. It's good for you. You'll not be happy without me. He knows that. He knows. So why is Krishna so much asking us to strike relationship with him, which you're avoiding? Because he knows we cannot be happy without him. He knows that. It's not that he is getting something. Chalo thoda nokar kam pade hain jaake le aao. Ek jaise college mein aata hai na placement department. So you said that he's maintaining after, not sir. That is he's already doing. All he has been asking throughout, my dear child, don't avoid me. You go to Devi Devatas, why do you avoid me? Come, no, my door is open. Just like you want to make your passport, okay? And the main passport officer, his door is open. And you go to the nearby, that karmachari, yeah, they take 2,000 bribe and get it done. My God, he's paying bribe also and still avoiding me. Where do you come? Come, my door is open, come. Don't have to pay any bribe, I'll do the work for you. But you avoid him. So therefore, imagine if there is a passport officer like that. We are avoiding him, going all around his karmachari. Door is open, visitors are allowed. We don't go to him. So he says, why you're avoiding me? What's your problem? Please come. He's inviting. But we don't come. We go to all neighboring places. We avoid him. Just like I give a serious example. You are in America. 20 years you stayed in America. You land in the same city. 20 years are over. Your parents are waiting to just see you, talk to you. And you avoid them. How much painful are the parents? We are actually like a dog's curtail. Seedha hi nahi hota. We will avoid him. That's the determination. Deliberate disobedience. So Krishna says, my dear child, come. I am your father. Because he is the source of the soul. He's the father. And by 15th chapter, we say, Mamayev Amsha. Just like a mother feels. I know how many mothers are here. Don't you testify? Don't you feel for the child? The child is part of your body. Don't you feel like that? You have a very special affection for your child. Why? He's part of my body. Don't you agree that feeling is there? But actually, if you go deeper, we are not the body, we are the soul. Krishna has a feeling for the soul. Mame Amsha, it's my part. And he can't leave it. That's why Krishna says, what are you trying to do? Just like say a child runs out of the home. Father, mother will go and talk to him. Don't say that. What are you trying to do? You want to break the relationship? It cannot be broken, sir. We are your parents. You cannot break the relationship. But still, this is temporary and material. Krishna has a right to say, Sanatana, eternally I am related to. What are you trying to do? Break a relationship? It's never possible. But still, just like Arjuna, he says, gives knowledge. Krishna is very gently gives the knowledge. And he says, now you decide what you want to do. So our decision. So you said, somebody had this question, you know, that every time I have to bow to him, you know, give me one glass of water. He is not, physical necessity is not talking. He is hungry for your love. He is hungry for your love. Say, Mike, just relate to me. Give me some flower. Give me, you know, I say, give me something. In the later chapters, will come, 9 chapter. Give me a flower. Give me a fruit. He's asking only those things which are not expensive. Patra, pusha, phala, toya. Anybody can give. Little flower, some water. That's all you can. You get. And who cannot do? Take a glass of water, keep in front of the Lord Krishna and start expressing his love. Love is not dilme. There has to be interaction. Then it grows. It makes sense. Yes, Anshu
Guruji,
Gupta.
Guruji,
no, Anshu Gupta, that is answer.
Prabhuji?
Yes.
Krishna is an avatar of Mahavishnu, so why don't we pray Mahavishnu only?
You are very intelligent. Very intelligent. What is your name?
Saranya.
Where? How old are you?
10.
Ah, Abba. So nice. See, I have sent you Goloka chart in the WhatsApp group. Can you study that? Yeah, when you get time, you study the whole chart. Then you will understand what is what.
Okay.
You see here. Okay? It is there in the WhatsApp group, but I'll briefly explain. This is a general understanding, common popular understanding, that actually Krishna is the avatar of Vishnu. But not if you study the chart now. You see in this. What happens actually, one thing is there first, before I start, there is no difference between Vishnu, Krishna, Rama. It is one person. God is not two, God is one. Okay? God is one, God cannot be two. So, Vishnu, Krishna, Rama is the same person. But still, the question may be, which is just like a candle, you write many candles, which is the original candle? That question will be there now. So, this you see, actually here, the creation starts from here. Goloka. Generally, understanding of society, that is what happens. Because in the material world, is maintained by Vishnu. This Vishnu we are talking. Mahavishnu, yeah, Shirodakshi. Actually, when you say incarnation, generally it's an incarnation of Shirodakshi Vishnu, Paramatma. Because Paramatma is the one managing this world. Whole task of managing the world comes to Shirodakshi Vishnu. Because therefore, he enters the heart of everybody, even inside every atom. He is the one seeing everything and maintaining. And he does decision in online decision making. Just like sometimes they say smart people. There was a person I remember in Manipal, a director. He also wanted to imitate God's smart decisions. So he came to the campus, cycle for everybody. And then immediately next day, 6,000 cycles are purchased. And the money deducted from the students' fees. Poor fellows. But Manipal is like this and this. Then within 1 month, 6,000 cycles were thrown. Can you imagine the joke? So we also try to take smart decisions like this. Some people, at that moment you want to take decision. It doesn't work. Don't try to imitate Vishnu. You plan before. But Vishnu is, he knows everything. Every moment he's taking a decision. Within a moment. Not that he has to think for hours and hours what decision. He makes a decision in a moment. Correct? So that is Vishnu maintaining and managing this world. Everybody according to his karma, kala, desires, he started managing. Now, this is, so anytime there is a problem in this world, this Paramatma resides also at, it has, he has this place also, known as Shira, Shirodakshay Vishnu. And I did show you Shirodakshay Vishnu in the class today. They go there to pray. They say all the Devi Devatas go here. See, they go and pray. You can see Lord Shiva is here, Brahma is there, Indra is there, all Devi Devatas collect together and go. And they offer Purushukta prayers to the Lord. And the Lord is hearing. And sometimes Lord gives darshan, sometimes he doesn't give darshan, just send the message. So you can see all the devatas pray to him. And then the Vishnu, when he studies the level of the problem, sometimes says, okay, I'll come. So Krishna then comes as an incarnation, Vishnu then comes as an incarnation. I will use Vishnu, Krishna, enter because it is the same person for me. But when Krishna is to come, actually, apparently it looks that this incarnation also came from Vishnu because Vishnu is the one giving all incarnation, which apparently looks like that, but it's not a fact. Why it's not a fact? Because of the Goloka chart. Here is the Lord residing in Goloka. Krishna expands to Balaram. You can note it down. Krishna explains to Balaram. Balaram explains to Sankarsana, Pradyumna, Aniruddha and Vasudeva. Then the Sankarsana here expands to Narayana. Then again Narayana expands to Sankarsana, Pradyumna, Aniruddha and Vasudeva. And the Sankarsana you are seeing here, he expands to Mahavishnu. Now Mahavishnu expands to Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Garbhodakshaya Vishnu expands to Shirodakshaya Vishnu. And you are saying all incarnations are coming from Mahavishnu or Shirodakshaya Vishnu. No, sir. That is true, except when Krishna comes. Krishna is not, he is coming from spiritual world. He is the original personality. Here. He is the Adi Purusha. Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami Chintamani Prakara Sadma Shukalpa Veksha Lakshavratesa Surabhi Avipalayantam Lakshmi Sahasra Shadasam Ravaseve Manam Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. So beautiful verses. I wish you all study, even later we'll teach you Brahma Samhita. Very, very nice book. Brahma Samhita should be studied by anybody who is having a doubt of relation of Krishna to the Devi Devatas. Every person is there in that book, and how it relates to Krishna is also given in detail by Brahma. Brahma Samhita is the PhD thesis of Brahma. Very clear, very detailed.
Prabhuji, what is the main difference between Shirodakshaya Vishnu, Garbhodakshaya Vishnu and Karnodakshaya Vishnu? Why are they expanded into three Vishnus?
Yeah, if you want to understand the creation, you should understand the three Vishnu. Mahavishnu, the pose of his body, you can see the universes are coming out. Can you see that? Therefore, his Maha is quite big. See, if you see the size of the elephant's sun, you know, he's more heavier than when he's born, the son of the elephant. Seeing him, we can know the mother must be also really big. So if the universe is coming out of somebody, even in the seedling form, the Vishnu has to be really big. Right? Because the universe is so big. That is Mahavishnu. Huge. And from the pores of his body, this, can you see that? He breathes out the universes from, just like we breathe out sweat. From pores of his body, universes come out. The universe is seedling. They get covered by the Mahatattva. This is the Mahatattva. And it covers in that, so many layers, it covers. And inside the universe, then Mahavishnu expands and as Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. It takes certain living entities with him and goes inside the universe. And then from the navel, he gives birth to Brahma. He doesn't need help of his wife. Directly gives birth to Brahma. That's omnipotence of the Lord. And then he expands to Shirodakshaya Vishnu. Functionally, they are different. Shirodakshaya Vishnu enters the heart of every living entity. And he also has a place, Shirodakshaya, Shira Ocean. It is there. All the devatas regularly come for offering prayers. Okay? Functionally, they are different. Otherwise, three. Creation means these three Vishnus. And it looks more logical. Now, you let us compare it as an outside observer. This detail and the detail which is given in other religions. What do other religions say? Let there be creation and there was creation. How? What are the details? No details. Here's so much detail. And this is, I'm just speaking with detail. The whole Bible, I'm just giving you the picture. Thousands of shlokas, the description is going on in the Vedic literature. This thing has been discussed. And you not find any contradiction to this anywhere. That I can assure you. So beautifully described. Huh? What they say, scientists, now let us take care of this scientist. What do they say? See, scientists, their problem is, they can do very small thing like bending iron and all, but they should not talk about creation and all, because see, presently the science is only understood little of matter, little. Otherwise, see, the vaccine they are saying we take one more year. Many people got a shock of their life. They thought the scientists will save them, and in front of the helplessly scientists are standing and people are dying. That illusion is broken, at least good. So, scientists, their domain is little matter they understood, little. That is not much. They make one medicine, it has 100 scientific, that comes to know tomorrow. Little matter they know, not much. They otherwise, why global warming occurred? They never knew what they are doing. Make one mistake and they try to solve the mistake, make another mistake. Then to solve that mistake, make another mistake. That is how the scientists function. But they have no knowledge of soul and God. No knowledge of soul and God. Little understanding of matter. You understand? It's like, and they think matter is everything. But in the second chapter itself, we reveal, and I showed you the slides, so when 18 reasons, so many scientists are actually now feeling that they are not on a solid foundation. Western science is based on Western philosophy. In Western philosophy, even the concept of soul is not there. And scientists, as the science has to progress now, they're feeling they have to come out of their pride and make Indian philosophy as a foundation. Then the consciousness comes in. Then God comes in. Correct? God, they also have in the culture, but no details are available. I told you, let there be creation. How can you compare that with this here? So much details are there. Even what is Mahatattva made up of in Sankhya, it will explain. So many elements are there. All the creation, so much details are there. That is one line that they, just like a pocket dictionary and multi-volume dictionary. But dictionaries are, both of them are correct, no doubt. But multi-volume dictionary is for senior people. Pocket dictionary for children.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yeah.
Prabhuji, can you please clarify one thing? It may not be probably related with what you told us today, but somehow I have a doubt with me. What really causes the emotions? Is it the mind or is it the heart?
See, what happens, the soul as such is the experiencer, no doubt. Finally, at the end of the day, experiencer is the soul. Okay? But presently, the soul is in a slumber and hold the power of attorney it has given to the mind. Just like, aap ghar mein hai. Now take this model. You are the master at home and you are sleeping. And you tell your servants, take care. So you're not totally dead asleep, but almost, you know, like, And your servants are managing the house and they're selling your whole house. Hey, aadha le ja 10 rupaye de mere ko. He's selling your expensive items for nothing practically. You are being cheated. So my mind intelligence is actually cheating me. Therefore, soul has to be woken up. Get up. And when he gets up, hey, kya kar rahe ho yaar? Ye sab wasting my time. Watching TV all day, doing all this. Okay. Come. And it takes, you have to take charge of the situation. So you are feeling the emotions. End of the day, experience is only the soul. But presently, the soul has given all the power attorney to the mind and intelligence. It is identifying too strongly, just like in the body now. Now, suppose there is a cut in the body. You feel pain. But it's illusion, no? You're not the body. Because you identify with the body, you feel pain. Therefore, some people are there, or yogis, you can do operation on them and they don't feel any pain. They can tolerate it. So I'm not the body. Okay, the anesthesia, I don't need anesthesia. You do. They can do live, you can do. No? They bear the pain. They know I'm not the body. So similarly, the emotion that we are having are also some gymnastics of the mind. And you can't dissociate with that.
This soul
has only one emotion. That is Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham. It's only one emotion, soul. Nitya Siddha Krishna Bhakta Sadhu Kabunaya Shavanadi Shuddha Chitta Karaya Udaya. Soul is waiting to serve the Lord. It just has to be woken up. It will run towards its Lord. Soul is never contaminated. It's always pure. Soul, you cannot burn it, you cannot cut it, you cannot dry it. That is one side, you know. Other side is, it's a great servant of the Lord. Just a little slumber. It has to be woken up. When you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, it wakes up. So when you're chanting Hare Krishna, one side it is purifying the mind, other side it is waking up the soul. And once the soul gets up, and soul only Sachidananda, full of happiness. Where is the sadness? It's all because of stupid mind and body. The soul is only happy. And it sees the Lord next to it who is standing and is so happy. So the emotions are all actually experienced by the soul, agreed. Just like pain is felt by the soul, agreed. But it is because of the wrong identification, no? With the body. And emotions with the mind. Okay. So you can therefore dissociate with the emotions and tolerate the emotions. Just like in Bhagavad Gita, when Krishna tells Arjuna at this point that you are not the body in the second chapter. So immediately Arjuna says, yeah, Arjuna will definitely say this question to Krishna. That Krishna, you know, Krishna gives a shloka, Devinaspani yatha dehe kaumaram yovanam jara tatha dehantara prapti dhirasudaranam hoyati. So Krishna, immediately Arjuna's question will be to Krishna. Krishna, okay, that's fine that I am not the body. But in front of me, when I see my grandfather dying, my teacher dying, it gives me a lot of pain. So Krishna says, yes. You have to tolerate, that's all. What can be done? Because illusion, you have to tolerate. Matra, Spasha, Stakonte, just interaction of the sense of the sense object, nothing to do with the soul. Sitoshna, Sukadukoda, sometimes hot, sometimes cold. Agama, Paino, Anityas, it comes and goes. Tikatam says, Arjuna, just tolerate it. So, see, emotions come in this world because we have given our love at a wrong place. And therefore, we had attachments are there, and people cheat us, people hurt us, and it pays. Agreed? Now you give
your heart. Thank you, Guru.
Now you give heart. No, I'm saying, give your heart to Krishna over. There is no more, you will have only happiness because he knows how to reciprocate. Yes, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yeah.
Prabhuji, you said that the soul is one only, but the bodies will be changing, no? But some people will know that, like, they will remember the past Janma, but some people won't remember, no? How can we understand that? Like, it is the same soul, no? We can remember then.
Yes, very nice. See, do you remember what you ate yesterday? So, okay, tell me this day, same date, 1 year ago, what did you eat? Today is date. What date it is? 28 July 2020. Tell me 28 July 2019. What did you eat in the breakfast? Can you tell me? You don't remember, no? Correct? Do you remember? We don't remember. So, just because you don't remember, it doesn't mean it didn't exist. I tell you, I studied engineering. I don't know how much Rohan has forgotten now. I don't remember one line. He also studied mechanical engineering. Me, you ask one word, I don't remember. One word also. 4 years, but they taught me so-called college. One word, I don't remember. But so can you say that therefore you never studied? I don't remember. That is true, but I can't say. And also one thing good. It is good to forget, I tell you. Suppose, you know, I told you the joke. Somebody got divorced recently. 30-year life, 30-year marriage. Everything from the day when she entered house, she told. Deva and to my sas looked at me like that. And that day you spoke. 30 years for things were like a tornado going in her head. So what do we do in life? It's better forget. And it's good that you forget. Otherwise, very difficult to live. Isn't it? It's good to forget. Forget and forgive and proceed in life. So it's good to forget things also. So there are various reasons by Krishna's arrangement. We don't remember past life. It is good. Now say you have some exam to be given. 12th class. Which class you are in now?
8th
class. Take care. Now, just imagine, I tell you that you have last life also, one more college of exams are pending. What do you say? Better forget. No, previous to that third life before, one more college, you have school, you have some exam pending. But no, better I forget. I don't want to remember. No, you have to give those examinations. So, better we forget. So many duties. You have to take care of that wife. You have to take care of the children. I forgot and I don't know anything. I don't know. No, that wife. Better forget. So, Krishna's arrangement, it is we forget. It's Krishna's arrangement, we forget. Sometimes, in once in a million case, some people remember. That shows, that becomes a proof. Because it is scientifically verified, it proves that past life exists. And we are the soul. But then why Krishna makes us forget, we can appreciate. No, all see, I tell you, when Krishna lifted mountain, if you were there, what do you say? Wonderful. What do you say? That's wonderful. And a small child lifting a mountain in a finger for 7 days, and the other hand is playing flute and laughing. No effort, huh? When the weightlifter is 100 kilo also, like this they will be doing. And looking at the judge, enough. Krishna, 7 days with the smallest of finger of the left hand. Okay, that's all it is. So, won't you say that is wonderful? Wonderful. So, everything Krishna does is wonderful. You start from that point. And you will find why he does that. Oh, wonderful. How it is wonderful? Proceed in that way. That is how we understand God. Okay, now you all wanted to see an amazing video on mind control or we'll see tomorrow looks like. You're 47 already, time is. Tomorrow, remind me. Okay, I have so many videos I just collected yesterday to show you. Now time where? Now is the time and most half of the people are gone away.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Very nice experience.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Guruji. Thank you, Mataji.
धन्यवाद प्रभु जी.
थैंक यू प्रभु.
धन्यवाद प्रभु जी. धन्यवाद गुरु.
नमस्कार प्रभु जी.